Hey, how's it going, everybody? Today we're going to be playing some Awilix. I'm also probably going to be uploading a small little Awilix clip I had a while back from Twitch onto YouTube today, so we'll have the full gameplay and then the little clip, which will be cool. But yeah, I hope you guys have been doing good. I've recently been playing Elden Ring and streaming it. That game is so fun. It's fun. The PC port does have some performance issues, but for the most part, it's really, 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 really fun. Let's see. We're against Vulcan, which means we should go blink. Do I want to go Bumpus Hammer for late game? That's not a bad idea. Yeah, let's try that. So we're going to start Transcendence into blink. Now, I think blink is really, really good against Vulcan because if he throws his meatball or whatever, you can blink right behind him. And then he kind of doesn't really have a great way out. And this matchup used to be really hard for me as a Awilix, but I've learned that what you got to do is you got to play, you got to go an auto attack build, kind of. Like, I still like to start Transcendence because the insane power and mana it gives. But if you go an auto attack build with, like, Hasten Katana, what you can do is you can blink on Vulcan, alt, and then just hold left click, and he can't get away from you because Awilix is knockup immune in the ultimate. She's slow immune in case he tries any like Gem of Iso shenanigans. And then she also can just stay next to him really easily with the feather step and stuff. So that's good. Alright, looks like he doesn't want to fight me. By me. Also, I thought I would say that I'm playing on new mouse settings. I've learned that my mouse settings were way too high for Smite. I had my DPI at 2350 and in-game sensitivity like 20 or something like that. And I've cut it like more than in half. And hopefully that'll help me with hitting things. But it is hard to get used to. So I think it'll make me a better player over a longer period of time. Because it's funny, because when you first start gaming, you think that a high sensitivity is good, right? Because if you have a high sensitivity, that means that you can like turn around extremely quickly and react and things like that, right? That's what went through my mind, and I kind of got used to high sensitivity. But the reality is a lower sensitivity is better because then you have more precision. You have more control. Because the difference between moving your arm or your mouse left and right isn't that big of a deal unless you're having to turn around constantly. But it's more of that precision of exactly the angle you want to turn around to. I also never could do 360s or anything like that because I just had no control over it. Maybe I will eventually. Your middle tower is under attack. We're also still kind of low rank, just because I've been I've been getting better with Atlas, but it has costed me a lot of MMR. I think I'm pretty good with him now. A lot, way better than the full gameplay I posted last. So I should probably post another one. Like, the difference is actually astounding in how I play Atlas now. I could ult him over the wall here, but would that be good for me? Oh, I actually didn't knock him up. Suku is supposed to knock you up if you are looking the other way or to the side. And he was looking to the side there. He was damaged. He was not knocked up. That's odd. I think I go for this. Whoops. Except that I missed. I didn't blink in time. That's a problem with using my feather step early too. I thought I could maybe burst him down instantly before he healed from his med and everything. But instead, I should probably save my feather step for the ultimate. That's okay. I wasn't expecting that much damage when he doesn't even have Bancroft's finished. We're all about that late game here. But so is Vulcan. So I'm probably going to go Shoguns next item. We want to start getting a little bit of auto attack, attack speed and stuff. Man, these low mouse settings is really throwing me off. Me. Good poke there. However, I think we have to recall. He does have more sustain and range. And I need at least tier 1 defense before I start fighting him. I don't actually like that starter item that he went too much. I don't build it very often. I like doing it on movement speed builds. Like, sometimes I'll go movement speed up wash. And then I'll upgrade into the focus upgrade, the one that gives movement speed. Alright, gold-wise, we're just a little bit behind. Not that much. I should actually try to steal his blue buff here. Just to try to not let him get too far ahead. Oh, he does have a ward on me. That was bad. I'm actually glad he didn't stay to engage. However, now I have blink. Now he's probably dead if he stays. Oh, unless I miss. That's so bad. Alright, well, I got blue, but missing the blink knockup's so bad. Oh, I did want to try a new start. Now, I think the better relic here would be upgraded sprint. That way I don't have to go for Asa Katana, especially because the upgrade where every time you auto attack, it extends the duration is just really good for stuff like this. But I think I want to try meditation, the one that knocks up, because I had that idea suggested by a commentator a while back, and I think it would be very fun to do. So basically you get meditation and you can knock them up. You can use your 3 however you want, but once you're ready, you can use meditation, knock them up for the ult, which is pretty cool. Because you have a way longer CC chain as a Awilix. If you knock them up some way, somehow first, you ult them and then you get behind them and then use your 3. You actually see me do that a lot against gods with escapes, like leaps, where they will leap away. I will ult, and then once they drop down in front of me, I'll get behind them and then use my 3 to knock them up again. It's just such a long CC duration. Oh, that's bad for me. That's bad. I'm only fighting him because I know his ult's down. But it's not really working out. Got my ult again. Oh, damn it. He knows. Your middle tower is under. He knows. He knows too much. I'm going to die here. I have to give up that wave and tower. That sucks. Oh, he knows too much.
My faithful squires know what to purchase.
Now, do I want to go hasten this early? I don't have too much pen.
Your middle phoenix is under attack. You can count on me.
Oh, also Hydra's Lament. Amazing item on Awilix now. Let's go Hydra's next, because now it has pen penetration. Once again, I'm canceling Suku. That way I can place wards and stuff, but then just getting right back on. Almost never worth to use the Suku leap unless you know you can get something. I've used it a couple times this game when I shouldn't have, to be honest. Damn, you do damage now. But he cannot outrun me, for I am too fast. Now, if I get meditation before you get your second relic, is that gonna be bad? You wouldn't. I mean, if they get horrific, it's fine. I'm still immune to my ult. Alright, let's try it. The other meditation upgrade is way better, by the way. But this one's can be interesting. It's See, there I use Suku, because if I got him to stop, that actually would be huge. And if he backs anyways, it doesn't matter. The cooldown, I don't really need it for the next 8 seconds or whatever. However long the cooldown is. Nah, he's already taken that, most likely. Okay, okay. How long is Suku 1 anyways? 12 seconds, and I have some cooldown too. I have 20% right now. With Hydras, I'll have 30% cooldown. That's pretty hype. That actually gives me the perfect amount of cooldown for late game with Power Potion. Just going all these 10% items. Pretty good. Okay, so now what do we want? We want Hydras, that's what I said, right? An upgrade, I definitely need it. I know not much is happening in this game, but that's just kind of what happens against Vulcans. I pretty much have to commit way too much to get a kill, unless he puts himself a tiny bit out of position. Like here, I could maybe try something, but he's at full health. So what good is that going to do me at the end of the day? Why did it not knock you up? Did I misread this item? Not that it matters. Maybe it does matter. Thank goodness for the mechanic where you could use Feather Step after hitting any damage with the Awilix, even if it's, well, I guess not any damage, but ability damage as well. So because I hit him with my 3, I was able to Feather Step on him. Because there's no way I was going to auto-attack him through all those minions. That was kind of scary. That was a sloppy fight. That was not a good fight. Let me reread meditation real quick. Because I haven't actually... This is like maybe my second time building it. You'll gain a protective barrier of wind that explodes if an enemy comes within 15 units, knocking them back. But it's a knock-up as well, isn't it? Like, I remember testing it in jungle practice. It's both, isn't it? Oh, what if they changed it? Oh, no. Or I just misremembered. Anyways, I'm going hasten now, because now I have some pen, I have cooldown. I kind of just need attack speed, and this gives attack speed. Then we'll get Bumba's Hammer. Probably finish hasten before getting Bumba's, even though it's not ideal, quote-unquote. Damn, nice turnaround. Surprised she's able to dodge that. You're kind of low health, dude. If I get close to him, I think I can kill him. He also got shell, though, so keep that in mind. I have my meditation in a few moments. Dude, it's not even knocking it back. You have slain an enemy. Do I have to do it out of combat first? Plus 3% of their missing health. Also, this guy F6 before his tower even died. That's so sad. So we didn't get the full Awilix game. But it's an Awilix game nonetheless. The important thing is that I used to struggle with this matchup, which means people picking up Awilix might have struggled with this matchup in the past. So hopefully I had some pointers that would help with that. Specifically when you're going into the late game too. Going an auto attack build where you can just alt and stay next to them. Wasn't really able to showcase that, but that's kind of what happened. Why can't I see the stats for this game? There we go. And like I said, my ranking is still extremely low to the Atlas games. But, oh well, I'll get back up there. Anyways, I'll see you guys. Hope you guys enjoyed and have a good day. Bye.